I've started running and operating the containers. Now it's time to access that application from outside. And to do that, I'm going to launch a container with a web server image. So I choose the Nginx image from Docker Hub. That's Docker Hub Explorer, and it shows me the Nginx as the first image. And I'm going to pick the latest version of Nginx is what I'm going to launch. I already know how to run a container, so I'm going to start using those common options, Docker container run hyphen IDT, and then the image name. If I don't provide the tag, it assumes latest. So I can either provide hyphen latest or colon latest, or I can just omit that. The command is automatically taken from the image. So when you build an image, you can also define the command that can be launched, which I'm going to show you in a later stage when you build a Docker file as well. So if you look at the Docker file here, and if you scroll down at the bottom, generally it has the command defined, and this is the command which is going to be launched automatically. And since it has been defined as part of the image metadata, I don't have to provide the command either, but I need another option, that is hyphen capital P. Remember, it's capital P, and we'll just see what happens when you use that capital P option. This is pulling the image for Nginx, which is a web server, and Nginx typically runs on port 80, and it has started running that application, and I see all the common output. Along with that, I have this new option that I see which shows me some 32769 pointing to 80. 80, I know that it should be in Nginx port. But what is that 32769? This is how the Docker works. So Docker is running inside my Docker host. That container is running that inside that host. The container is running on port 80. And from inside, I can access it from 80. But if I want to access it from outside, either using a browser or even my laptop where I'm running container inside a VM, I can reach out to that VM or the Docker host, but not to the container. To access that, you have to map that port. And that's what has happened here. So that 32768 or 32769 is the port that Docker has picked up automatically. Docker has some default mechanism. So when I use capital P, it automatically knows, it reads the port from my image, and it points it has pointed 32769 from my host, which is a Linux server running remotely, this is the IP of my host, to that container. So I'm going to access it using the combination of my host colon mapped port, not the container port, the left-hand side port. So if I go to 32769, I land on that Nginx containers web page. And that is that port mapping all about. Now, if I run more than once that same command, it would launch. Every time I use Docker run, it launches a new container. And since I'm using capital P, it automatically increments the port number. So not only I have 32769, but now I also have 32770 and 771, which is pointing to the new containers respectively that I am running here. This is how the port mapping works. And the IP address depends on your environment. So if you're using Docker for Mac or Docker for Windows, you use localhost. If you are using, let's say, Docker Toolbox, the IP address will change to your VM's IP, which is typically 192.168.99.100 or 99.101. So according to your environment, that IP address and the port mapping and the IP address, the URL will change. You can also define a specific port. So if you want to point, let's say, port 8888 to 80, instead of that automatically generated port number, you can use small p. Left hand side is the host port, right hand side is the container port. So now my host's 8888 is also pointing to the newly created container's 80 port. That's another Nginx running right there. And just like this, you can actually launch any application using the information that you have learned so far. I'm going to show you running an application. It's a web-based, publishing platform, an application called as Ghost. It is similar to WordPress. It's a content management system, created using Node. Now, if you want to run an application, just search for an image and you should be able to launch it with any of these tags. You can use the default commands, Docker container run hyphen IDT hyphen capital P and the image ID. A lot of times you'll also see in the documentation the instructions to run that container. That's what I'm going to rely on, and it is very similar to what we typically use and it has few additional options. Now this is missing hyphen int, so it is always safe to add those options. I generally use that hyphen idt combination and I recommend that. I added a name to be ghost. I changed the name to ghost, and this is using a port mapping which is 3001 to 2368, and I'm going to just customize that image. I'm going to pick an image called as with the tag alpine. And that's all you would need. So, and similarly, you should be able to launch any application from Docker Hub using a combination of commands similar to this or something on these lines. So it is pulling the image. It is going to launch the application. If I run Docker PS minus L, it shows me the last run container, which is this ghost application. And it has done the port mapping. So the same IP, but host IP, that is Docker host IP, colon port 3001 should show me that it is running on, you know, it should be running. I just use Docker logs command to find out whether that application has started or not, which has. So if I just point to 3001, this is my application. And it just takes few minutes or even less than a minute a lot of times to launch an application. That is just amazing. You can actually run any application, anything that you want. You never have to worry about installing that application, or because Docker gives you the complete package, which is self-sufficient with the application, all dependencies, including the file system. You could also use Docker stop to stop a running container. So if you've launched an application, you want to work with it later as well, you can stop it, you can start it. I just see that in a stopped state, and I can start the same container using the start command. You don't have to use run commands again. So don't use run command, because it will launch a new container and you might not see the data, and you might think that Docker is just, you know, ephemeral and my data is lost. It's not the case. You can start the same container using Docker start, either the container ID or the name. And before I did that, I just showed you that it's been stopped. And if I start it back again, now it is running. So if I go back to the browser and reload, I have the application with the same state that I had stopped it with. This is how you can run the containers. So you should be able to, using these commands and the information and the port mapping, go ahead and try out running some containers or the applications from Docker Hub.